those are the two guys that will help not only put the coaching staff together next year, but also put the team together next year. And I really like the fact that instead of picking a team and taking it to camp, they make that mini camp more competitive right before the tournament starts to make sure they've got the 22 they want.
And it will be in Calgary and Edmonton next year. The largest attendance for a juniors game came in Ottawa. Here in Buffalo, the record is the second most attended game, most attended tournament. And the Canadian fans had a big part of that, obviously. But the crowds were really great here and will be great tonight for that Canada-Russia game.
And that should be a great game. These are two teams that are very similar in style. Canada's like the Yankees. They think they should win it every year. Russia, all of a sudden, in a gold medal game, they were not sure they were going to get here. So now that they're here, they know they're 60 minutes away. They should be great tonight.
Nothing to lose, right? All right, that's going to do it here in Buffalo. We thank all of you for joining us, and our congratulations to Team USA. The hope had been that they would be able to get that gold game. Canada wanted revenge on Team USA. Everybody thought coming in that it probably would end up those two teams playing in the gold game, but it didn't. Canada had to play a quarterfinal as they suffered a loss in the first round of the tournament. They got by that, and Team USA and Canada met in the semifinal. Canada came away with a 4-1 win in that game, forcing Team USA to have to regroup and make this medal game for the bronze an effort. And that is exactly what they did, and they came away with the bronze, and our congratulations to them. Final score here was 4-2 over Sweden. The preceding has been an exclusive presentation of USA Hockey, the International Ice Hockey Federation, and the NHL Network. For Dave Starman, Fred Pletch, Billy Graff, and all Billy Jaffe, I know Billy Graff, but he's not working here. Billy Jaffe and all of our crew here in Buffalo, I'm Gary Thorne. Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Hope you enjoyed it. This juniors team did an outstanding job representing the United States, and the bronze is theirs. Following our game tonight, we'll take you behind the scenes. The highlights coming up of that special day, 6:30 Eastern, and that's just about a couple minutes from now, where we'll see the Legends game that was played at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh. From Buffalo, we bid you adieu.
And there is Mario Lemieux entering the Pittsburgh locker room to play for perhaps one last time.
Welcome, everybody, to the NHL's Legends Classic from Heinz Field. Here today, we are going to bring you some beautiful hockey. It's a scary kind of situation because Mario Lemieux, Glenn Healy, is going to come back and lace them up again.
Yeah, this is no ordinary alumni game. This is the 1972 Caps against the 1992 Penguins. The Caps have four fourth lines, and Mario Lemieux is back in the house. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me when I played with the Toronto Maple Leafs, and Mario Lemieux came out of retirement. It was a December 27th game, and we stepped on the ice for warm-up, and it was packed in the building. And I thought, are we late for the game? No, Mario's back in the house, and he's back today, and it's going to be a great show. This is one that I would pay as a player to watch, and I can't believe we're getting paid to watch it from ice level.
Yep. Yeah, and Mario will be in full uniform today with other members of the team. Kevin Weeks is with us on board, and he's standing by at the Consol Energy Center with players in today's game.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, with Hall of Fame defenseman Paul Coffey back for the alumni game. Paul, the silkiest skater to ever lace the skates up, everybody knows that. But for a lot of the younger fans that never got a chance to see you play, what is this going to be like for you to reunite with a lot of old friends here this morning?
Well, it's great. I mean, you walk into the locker room here and some things just don't change, as you know, being a former player. It's nice to see all the guys that we played with or played against. And, you know, as for being a silky skater, I don't know if it's going to happen anymore, but it'll be a lot of fun. It'll be great.
So Mario gives you a call, you answer the phone. What's it like to get that call from him and, again, get a chance to come back and lace him up with him and a lot of your former teammates?
All of a sudden I get a call from Mario. I said, you playing? He goes, yeah. And I said, okay, I'm in.
So was that easy then?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it'll be great. It'll be fun.
I think this is how you do it. I just need somebody to tie my skates.
With two legendary former Pens here, and Kevin Stevens and Rick Tocchet. Guys, what's the game plan for this morning? Give the fans a little insight on what the game plan is going to be like for this morning.
They were all itching. Who gets to play with Mario? That's about it.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a lot of pressure to just play with Mara. I'd rather play with Dickie, give him the puck, watch him chop it up for a couple of periods.
Dump it in. Dump it in all day.
You look at the collection of the players in the locker room, all you guys. What does it mean to be back with a lot of your teammates that you had so much success with?
Well, you know, it just brings back memories. You know, like, I haven't seen Ronnie Francis other than when coaching against him. you know, obviously Kevin and all the guys, Bobby Erie, Paul Coffey, haven't seen him in a while. So, you know, all it does is just bring back memories when you win. You know, people go in different directions in their life after, you know, when you retire and stuff. But when you come back, you always have the one common thing is that we want a cup together and, you know, those stories come back. Hey, Artie?
What about for you, Kevin?
Yeah, it's nice being back in the room again. You know, this is kind of, you know, you spend so much time when you play hockey, you know, you spend so much time in here. We had a pretty close-knit guys, and just good to see all the guys back here, you know, and seeing just to get in the room. It's kind of like, you know, this is where you're comfortable. You know? Yeah. You know, I'm more comfortable here than, like, you know, sometimes sitting in my own living room. You know, sometimes it's nice coming in here and just, you know, seeing the guys and seeing everybody up early this morning. So it's fun. It's fun to be back.
Red to red.
That's my stick. You want to take it?
I'm inside the Caps alumni locker room with former goaltender Don Beaupre, and also with, as you would know, one of the faces of the Caps TV, Craig Laughlin.
Wide open, Mario shot! Oh, what a save! Don Beaupre!
You're going to be facing Mario again. What's that going
to
be like?
It's a privilege to play against guys like him again. You know, close to 50 years old, never thought I'd get a chance to play with these guys, but so it's going to be good. I mean, they've got a locker room full of Hall of Fame guys, and we got a lot of good players here too, a lot of nice guys. It's good to catch up, but it'll be fun to get back to what bonds us all together, get on the ice.
You do a lot of critiquing usually. Oh, yeah. You're not critiquing, but you're the eyes in the sky. Yeah. You see, now you know that now the shoe's on the other foot, right, for this morning. People are going to be watching. Are you ready for this game this morning?
Well, as I often say, it all comes down to ice time, and I think I can perform extremely well with a lot of ice time, having the puck a lot, playing two-minute shifts, and if I do that, I'm going to be a go-to guy, I think.
So with the players all ready to go, right, boys, they'll board some buses and head over to Heinz Field. And when we come back, we'll join Kevin on the bus as he catches up with number 66 himself, Mario Lemieux.
This NHL Network presentation is brought to you by Reebok, the official outfitter of the NHL.
Energy drink for your feet. ZigTech. I get more train, less pain.
On the break-in, scores!
After their semifinal win, Canada goes for the gold. The 2011 World Junior Championship gold medal game. Tonight, 7:30 Eastern on NHL Network.
No one ever got better at hockey by bowling. More practice for you.
Show your commitment to the game with the U+ Crazy Light from CCM. Get your fit on.
Demons are the devil's foot soldiers.
Choosing not to believe in the devil won't protect you from him. The terror is real, Michael. It's real.
Father?
What's happening to me?
The Right starts January 28th.
Introducing Cisco Yumi. Be together in high def on your TV. Exclusively at Best Buy's Magnolia stores. Cisco.
Over to Lemieux. Mario Lemieux, his first goal in his comeback here tonight.
All right, Glenn, and today the weatherman's been cooperative, and it's going to be a pretty nice day to play hockey.
It's going to be great. You know, the one thing that concerns me if I was a goalie would be sunshine. And we don't have sunshine. We've got a cloudy day, so they'll be able to see the pucks. If Lemieux's playing, they'll be able to see them go by them and pick them up and go back to center. But it is a great day. Temperatures are fantastic. Conditions are fantastic. Let's hope for much more of the same tomorrow, but for today, it's spectacular.
You were talking about Lemieux. Kevin Weeks is on the bus with Mario. Let's join them now.
We have in our presence, kind enough to allow us on the Pittsburgh Penguins alumni bus, the player, owner, Hall of Famer, Mario Lemieux. Mario, thanks so much for giving us some of your time.
My pleasure.
Now, Mario, what does it mean to be back out here with a lot of your buddies?
Well, it's a special day for all of us. I mean, we had some great years together with all these guys, winning two cups here in the early 90s, and just to have a chance to play outdoor in such a great venue and be a part of this weekend makes it very special for all of us. So it should be a great day for us.
Just being on this bus, you get the atmosphere and you get a sense of how tight-knit your teams were when you played.
Yep.
And you've created that. You talked about the free agency. You've been able to create that same type of atmosphere now as an owner. How do you do that?
Well, I think you create a family atmosphere, and that's where it starts. Starts from the top with the general manager, the coaches, the trainers are very important, and that's what we've been able to do throughout my career here, and especially now with Ray Shiro, really changed the culture when he came, and we have really become a great family here in Pittsburgh, and it helps a lot in the winning category when everybody's very close. So that's something that we try to do every year. We enjoy spending time together.
Mario, it's been our pleasure having you. Thanks so much for joining us.
Well, Glenn, there's other players playing in this hockey game besides Mario Lemieux, and for the Pittsburgh Penguins, the Hall of Famers come to mind. You can talk like Paul Coffey.
Yeah, Washington's probably looking at that roster thinking, does he really have to come today? Hey, this is a guy, when you look at him, his first year as a rookie, he had 9 goals as a defenseman. 4 years later, he had 40. And he is just a spectacular player, skates effortlessly, and I would think you'd watch him today, it'd be the exact same thing. But 3 Norris trophies, and he's a handful on any day, on any night, against any team, even if he is retired.
Well, you got to look at Ron Francis, too, who was a captain of this club, along with Mario Lemieux, at certain points in his career, and he's a great leader and a great player.
Yeah, I look at Ronnie, and the thing I think about, 22 seasons in the NHL, you think about the Selke, you think about the Lady Bings, a classy guy in every way, and, you know, he's playing on the second line today. Yeah. Isn't that the same way he always played in Pittsburgh, second line? I'm sure Washington's going, wow, that second line's pretty darn dangerous.
Francis comes in, shoots and scores! Ronnie Francis!
Let's turn our attention to the Washington Capitals. Michael Bavanka is certainly a familiar name to
Washington.
Horizon, rule the air.
What will it take for 50,000 people to honor family and friends, to surpass their own limits, to celebrate their ability to triumph over women's cancers one step at a time? What will it take? Momentum. Join us May 8th for the Entertainment Industry Foundation Revlon Run Walk for Women and discover your momentum. Register today at RevlonRunWalk.org.
Warning, Accutane, the acne drug used by millions, has been linked to severe side effects. The acne drug Accutane has been linked to serious side effects, including ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, and inflammatory bowel disease. If you've taken Accutane and developed Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, or inflammatory bowel disease, call now for a free legal consultation.
Call 1-888-888-9312. 1-888-888-9312.
Welcome back to the 2011 Legends Classic. Well, Glenn, it's kind of an interesting format here they have for this Legends Classic game they're going to have today. It's going to be 2 20-minute periods.
Well, if I was a Washington Capitol player, that's all I want. I don't want 3 20-minute periods. Have you taken a look at the Penguins roster? I mean, you talk about some Hall of Famers, and it is a different game, but you can sense the excitement of both teams. You know, you come on the ice, they have a nice little picture, everything's friendly. Mario taps everybody in the shin pads as he goes by, but you can guarantee one thing. Athletes are all competitive, and when the puck drops, the team in blue is not going to want to lose to the team in red. So I'm looking forward to a pretty good match this afternoon.
Well, we'll be talking with some of the players on the ice today. Mario, Bob Airey, and Nick Kiprios.
Who do you got on your line today, Kipper? Not that it matters with you.
I'm lobbying for Peter Bondra.
And Michael Pavonka maybe in the middle?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And what are you going to get, you think?
And I'll be the third man high.
Yeah. Who do you think you're getting, though?
Probably Alan May.
Oh, nice. Well, that would be the exact same as when you played with Washington.
Yeah. All right. Okay, I'm starting, I guess.
All right, Kipper, thanks. Donnie Beaupre is going to be in net for the Washington Capitals. The Penguins are going to start Gilles Meloche, Bill Guerin, Mario Lemieux, and Kevin Stevens.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, keep your head up.
Michael Pavanka is going to work with Peter Bondra, and the puck controlled by Paul Coffey. He'll sneak it up here to Billy Guerin, and Guerin had his pass picked off by Pavanka. Soft little pass into the Penguins in, and Bondra takes the first shot of the game, and that's going to miss. Peter Bondra, 503 goals in the National Hockey League. Here's a steal by Lemieux, and his outlet pass to Guerin, right back to Mario. Drop it to Guerin, trying to go through the defense, and he can't quite do it, and Beaupre able to angle it off. Two 20-minute periods, that's what we'll play here. Guerin trying to fire it to the net, and that's deflected. And Lemieux handles it again. Coffey's pass, broken up. And Bondra coming down that left wing. Working against Coffey, still controlling his Bondra. Right in front, and May tried to redirect. That just deflected wide. Coffey again. Long shift for Paul Coffey on that first minutes of play.
And the current Penguins, like Sidney Crosby, are certainly getting a kick out of seeing these legends out there on the ice.
Oh my God, is that Borky?
Yeah.
Oh.
But everyone's feeling each other out. You know, let's see what this alumni game's all about. Everyone's going to have fun, but the competitive juices will fly soon.
Gary Roberts on that right side to Tockett, and he couldn't make anything happen. Tockett's back on that puck to the right point. Peter Tagliannetti, the defenseman for the Penguins, over to Phil Bourque, and he shoots it towards the net. Not going to happen. Francis with a centering pass, and John Drews has it for Washington. Into the Penguins in, Dean Evason right in front to May. Well, May's had a couple of quick opportunities here in this first period.
Yeah, it's the wrong guy getting the opportunities. Hey, yeah, look at this second line for Pittsburgh, though.
Where are you going?
Oh, yeah, good block, locker. Picard tried to knock it down.
Oh, yeah.
Mario, I know the setting's got to be just magnificent for you and all the work that's gone into
to make it happen
here in the city of Pittsburgh.
Well, thank you. It's been a great last few years for us, and this is a special day for all of us. I think I'm up. Here we go.
There you go.
Let's do something out
Thanks,
here, Mario.
Mario.
You always did it against me. It's about time.
Tagliannetti on that far side to Bourque, and he'll loft it down the right wing to Robbie Brown, who is a great line made for Mario Lemieux, perhaps in the games that I've done all these years. The best, that's a score right there. Did Tagliannetti get in front there? Peter Tagliannetti cruising by the net. And the Pittsburgh Penguins strike first here in this alumni game.
We're wearing our end.
Nice pass. I threw a grenade out there.
Kevin Weeks is down ringside talking today with these legends, and he's with a couple of them now.
We're here with Peter Bondra, Mikhail Pavanka. Thanks so much for joining us. How are you guys feeling right now?
Thanks, Kevin. We need to catch a breath. Can you wait 5 minutes? But no.
You guys are so important to the history of the Washington Capitals, especially for European players. You guys were trailblazers. When you look at what you did, obviously you lived your dream playing. But now you look and you see a lot of the young European stars that are playing for Washington. How proud are you guys to see that?
Well, first of all, it's really exciting to watch Washington. I like to come to the game, and the way they play and what they bring to a game, like, it's a lot of fun to watch, and I really enjoy to come to the game. But overall, the game has changed, and always see youth dominating. And you know, if you draft well, the Capitals did well in the past 3 or 4 years, I think you're going to do well.
Obviously, the style has really changed. It's a lot more of a European/North American game now. Are you guys happy to see that?
It's more fun to watch. It's, you know, a lot more offense and all that. You got the players with the skills, they dominate the game, obviously. But, you know, the speed is still there. If you can skate, you can play. Now, we got the guys 6'3", 240, and they can skate. When we, you know, 10 to 15 years ago, they couldn't skate. That's the difference. The guys are really good.
Absolutely. Guys, thanks so much for joining us. All right, rest up. All right, thanks, guys.
Great story in John Drews, too. You think back to those
times in the playoffs. You know, they weren't happy with John Tucker, and so all of a sudden they put him on a line with the big boys. You know, they put him on a line with Hunter and Cortnell, and what a playoff run he had.
He had a legendary run.
Yeah.
Seriously, 14 goals, what, 15 games?
15 playoff games.
Yeah, that was magnificent. Right back, and that puck deflected in by Malosh. Yes, it did.
Tag's got another one.
And so the Washington Capitals striking and coming back to tie this hockey game.
Nice shot, Allen. Nice shot.
I can't get off the minus train. I can't get off the minus train. Continuation from last year.
This NHL Network presentation is brought to you by CompuWare, the technology performance company.
On the break, it scores!
After their semifinal win, Canada goes for the gold. The 2011 World Junior Championship gold medal game. Tonight, 7:30 Eastern on NHL Network.
It's supposed to rain tomorrow. Probably can't paint the garage.
Really? Like I haven't seen that movie. I got this amazing meal with McDonald's Dollar Menu. The beefy McDouble, the crispy McChicken. Everything's so good and just a buck each. I'm smart enough to do all that, so my turn.
Can't paint, huh? Guess we'll just have to go look at window treatments.
Too easy. McDonald's Dollar Menu, the simple joy of being smart.
Crosby, behind everybody, hit along, scores!
It's a bitter playoff rematch as the Penguins head to Montreal. Evgeny Malkin and the Penguins.
Malkin shooting, scores! Evgeny Malkin!
Scott Gomez and the Habs.
Rebound off the post and in! Scott Gomez!
Penguins Canadiens, Thursday, 7:30 p.m. Eastern on NHL Network. Brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on your car insurance.
Welcome back, hockey fans. It's been quite a game so far. I'm here with Joe Beninati and Craig Laughlin. Gentlemen, it's a real pleasure.
Certainly is. And now a message from our sponsor. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Joe, don't do this.
With competitive rates and great customer service.
Craig, are you going to jump in here?
GEICO, proud partner of the NHL.
Real nice.
So we've got a 1-1 tie here in this first period. And here's Sabrin cruising to the Penguins' net. And his backhander comes off Malosh's stick. Lofthouse coming near side. And Sabrin.
Season of the NHL, never scored fewer than 24. And boy, he had a knack around the net.
Very smooth. Here's Dave Hannon. A little drop pass.
There it is.
And that's a wrist shot right in the goal.
Hi, Greggy.
All right. Yeah.
Bobby, another plus.
And now we go to Kevin, who's down by the ice with current Penguin Pascal Dupuis.
How exciting is this for you guys to not only be able to watch the alumni and Mario and all the great players, but also to be playing in the Winter Classic for yourself tomorrow?
You know what, we're here today. All the guys came in really early this morning to watch the alumni game and just to get ready to see the fans and see the stadium.
You obviously grew up in Quebec playing on the outdoor rinks, playing on ponds. What is this like for you to be able to do this in an actual NHL game?
Yeah, you said it, national NHL game. You know, it's playing outdoors. That's where we grew up. That's where we kind of perfected our skills a little bit as a young guy, but at the same time, it's going to be great. This place is going to be packing and rocking.
All right, Pascal, thanks for joining.
Thanks, Vixie.
Here's Dean Evason. We go back.
A young
chance to get to see Mario Lemieux. Hey, I'm a fan as well. I want to see Mario Lemieux back on the ice.
Here's Bork with a little special move. Carries it on his stick.
We're joined by Mike Rupp, number 17 of the Pittsburgh Penguins. Mike, what does it feel like to have a chance to see your owner, Mario Lemieux?
It's awesome. From the second step in here today, nothing's but impressive things have been happening here the last few days. And to be able to see 66 out here and some of these other players I watched growing up is something special, that's for sure.
Mike, thanks so much for joining us. We really appreciate it, man.
Suffolk, send that puck in. Penguins break it up. Here's Lemieux. Might have some room here. Simpson on the right side. They look in front for Airy, and he can't get it to it. Bobby Airy scored a lot of his goals from right in front of that cage. And he was in the cage a lot of times, too, when he ended up with goals.
You have to ask your broadcast partner about fisticuff that he had with Glenn Healy. One of the Islander-Pittsburgh games, him and I decided to get at it. I grabbed the smallest guy in the Pittsburgh Penguins, of course, which was your broadcast partner, Bob Airy. And when I opened up my eyes from all the swinging I was doing, I had Mario Lemieux. He looked at me and he said, "What are you doing?" I apologized and we moved on and we played.
I heard the story another way. Just kidding.
Yeah. No, it's the way fables are, right? The legend grows.
Molas is going to get the puck to Larry Murphy. He's also in the television business, working now in NHL tonight, and also Detroit. He's done a lot of work. Right in front. And Stevens can't finish.
What a story, Larry Murphy. I mean, obviously, he's got the credentials in every way, 20 years in the National Hockey League. More games played than any defenseman ever. Which is a pretty good stat. The stat that stands out to me, 15 straight Stanley Cup final wins. Lost to Minnesota 2-1, and then he rattled up 15 straight from that moment on. And that's one of the reasons that he's sitting with all the Stanley Cup rings that he has.
Bullock's going to shoot it, and that's off the stick of Hannon.
Good shot. Good shot.
Looks like Kevin is back with Pascal Dupuis.
All right, for all you Pens fans out there, Pascal Dupuis somehow squiggled his way back onto our show. And yeah, you see he's giving it to Bill Guerin in the background. Pascal, tell the folks a little bit, now that Bill's here live, tell the folks what you were saying before about still letting these, you think.
Pretty much let the young guys play. Eh? That's why.
That's what I'm doing.
That's
why I stepped down for you.
Gosh. I couldn't believe I said that one day, but you look like the fastest player out there.
Are you kidding me? Seriously? I was 104 last year playing in the NHL and still faster than Duper. Well, hey, Duper's as fast as he can be. He still hasn't found the directions of the corners yet, though.
Yeah, good for those boards out there.
With his pace, with his skating ability, where would he rank among you guys right now playing in this alumni game, speed-wise?
Probably the fastest and the worst hands.
Come on. Maybe you guys can tell the fans a little bit about what it meant to win a cup in Pittsburgh and now getting a chance to reunite here.
It was unbelievable. I mean, this is such a great sports town, and to bring in a championship was pretty amazing. And you know, you get tie pretty good bonds together with the guys you do it with.
Thanks so much for joining us, guys.
Everson leads the parade back. The Mulvey on the left wing. Back to Lofthouse. And again, he's got the biscuit. Right in behind the Pittsburgh goal. I don't think he has to worry about too much about playing in this game now for Lofthouse. And the nervousness has gone away. Coffey trying to scoot by people as he did in his career. And here he comes flying down that right wing.
Oh, look at
it. Many of plays he made just like this. Playing in the National Hockey League.
No, we were always taught. Coff gets the puck, gets full retreat. Get back, because you know you're not going to contain him. You do your best to force him to bad areas of the ice, but with the speed, the vision, pace for you had
there so far.
Pretty slow. As you can tell, it's pretty slow, but no, it's a great day for hockey to be out and playing in this beautiful facility. The guys are having a good time, and hopefully the fans are having a good time as well.
Now, one thing that's interesting is you guys are really enjoying playing, but there's still a little competitive spirit in everybody. Let's be honest. Are guys trash talking out there a little bit?
Yeah, a little bit.
I never did.
Oh,
yeah. Just let the stick do the work.
That's
let
right.
Your stick do
That's
your
right.
talking. Now everybody's assembled. You guys seem like you're in good spirits. Nobody seems too tired yet. What are you expecting for the second half of the game?
Well, we have 20 minutes left, so we're going to go all out for 20 minutes and hopefully win this game for the fans here.
Awesome. Thanks so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
We'll return with the second half from Heinz Field after this.
These are the Bose Quiet Comfort 15 noise-canceling headphones, engineered to make air travel quieter, more relaxing, and to make listening to music more enjoyable. Bose was the first to introduce noise-canceling headphones over 20 years ago, and now QC15 headphones set an entirely new standard. Seth Porges of Popular Mechanics states that, compared to the competition, the QC15s are vastly superior. Murray Hill of Canada.com calls the sound quality and noise canceling amazing and says these are fabulous. And with a very comfortable fit, you won't find any other headphones like them. When you fly, engine roar fades away. You'll also hear a lifelike music reproduction you may never have experienced. Try QC15 headphones for 30 days risk-free with free shipping. Compare them to any other headphones and judge for yourself. Quiet Comfort 15 headphones. Performance that's only from Bose.
Every 60 seconds, someone, somewhere, is making the switch to Tempur-Pedic. Now, it's your turn. Call now for your free information kit, including a Tempur material sample, along with a DVD and catalog. Traditional mattresses use metal springs that can cause pressure points, causing you to toss and turn. Only the Tempur-Pedic mattress automatically adjusts to your body while keeping your spine in perfect alignment. Plus, because Tempur-Pedic doesn't transfer motion, you won't disturb your partner when you get out of bed or shift positions. Best of all, Tempur-Pedic will let you sleep on one of their sleep systems for an incredible 90 nights before you make your purchase decision. If you want the ultimate in comfort, if you wish to get more sleep but can't, it's time you make the switch to Tempur-Pedic.
Call 1-800-270-4243 for your free information kit. That's 1-800-270-4243. Call today.
All right, between periods right now and the play of the two teams.
I think it's been a great start to the day. I mean, you've got a good crowd here. They all want to watch the guys that they probably have their sweaters hung up in their closet somewhere. They don't fit anymore. Some of the guys that are wearing sweaters here, they don't fit anymore either. And I think everybody's just waiting for Mario Lemieux to put one in the back of the net. And if he does that, then the place is going to erupt. But it's been a pretty good pace, pretty competitive, and it's been a pretty even match.
Yeah, I will. I've one-on-one with him, so I'm going to let him win it. These are the stats I keep track of stats.
All right, Greg Laughlin against Mario Lemieux. And we'll begin playing. Larry Murphy is going to give that puck to Coffey. Now you got your Coffey and Murphy out here at Lemieux. Lemieux in front, Brown just had that one go wide. Well, Rouse trying to make the play at center. Brown steals, and Robbie Brown comes to Lemieux down that left side. Looking in front. Finish.
Some things never change. You know, Rob Brown gets the puck. What's the first thing he looks for? 66. You know, it's the same thing when you play with Gretzky. If you're ever on his line, get the puck hit, you give it to me. And if you don't give it to me, you won't be on my line for very long.
Well, the one good thing is if you give it to him, you got a pretty good chance of getting it back.
And in a better spot.
Yeah. Coffey. These guys move the puck. Lemieux can't get it on the cage. We got a 3-3 tie early in this second half. 20-minute periods they've agreed to play here. Well, this is morning. And Sabrin waves his arms, desperately wanting to get off. And then we have an icing call, our first icing call of the game.
They're blocking shots.
Oh, I know. They're holding my stick. Blocking
shots. Unbelievable.
They're ripping it in. They don't know where to go.
There's Kiprios. Walks right in. Just couldn't get it to the net.
Give him Coffey back the way he knew it was Kiprios. No harm here. Just give him the shot.
Long shift here. Trottier has gotten on. Murph and Coffey. A lot of time on the ice. Here's Lofthouse again. Pushes that one offline. Game is tied at 3 here in the second half. 15 minutes left. Trottier trying to weave through traffic. There's that name again. Lofthouse with a puck. Right down the right wing. Evison in front. Mulvey's going to poke it right in, and Washington has the lead, 4-3. Paul Mulvey. Oh, pretty setup play there. All you had to do is just put your stick out, and in it went.
You know, that was all.
I had to take that puck off you.
And we go back down to Kevin, who's with Caps head coach Bruce Boudreau.
Coach, what's it like to see some of these guys back in uniform again, especially Mary?
Great. I just don't know how much they've been skating out here, but they look about as fast as me, so that's good.
When you look at your current roster of the Caps, do you see anybody on either of these two teams from the veteran players of past from this alumni game?
No one ever got better at hockey by bowling. More practice for you.
Show your commitment to the game with the U+ Crazy Light from CCM. Get your fit on.
If I could have any job, I would still be making it, selling shoes.
I need those.
Yeah, the jewel terms.
I love the BlackBerry style. Flip phone's great. For me, it's cleaner and tighter, and here's the pocket call. Social feeds is a good way to let the world know about the product that's in the shop, and it's a good connection to the city.
Looks good.
Later. Take care.
Commit to the flip. This is what time it is.
Introducing the new BlackBerry style, available from Sprint. Yeah.
Welcome back to the 2011 Legends Classic. The Penguins rushing towards the net.
Los Angeles, here we go, we're going to get the penalty.
Yeah,
now.
Robbie Brown pulled down. They want a penalty shot. Gary Risling barking away, but I don't think that's going to be the call.
Hey, don't you know this one?
Weaver's got on a trip.
Come on, Weaver, don't look the other way.
What kind of trip was that? Hey, come on!
Robert Picard is going to be the guilty party, and he'll have to sit down, and now with the game 4-4.
Getting really serious.
6:55 to go, and it'll be a Pittsburgh power play here.
So he was one of those steady game coaches as well we talked about on the back end.
So he had a lot of pressure on him at that early part of his career to perform and be a superstar. And it wasn't easy for him. Here's Lemieux on the power play. Down to Simpson. And around that net is Bob Erie. Bob Erie's on the power play. Trying to get in a lane here. Oh, the net's off the moorings.
You know, when you play a team like Pittsburgh and they've got, you know, you look at every one of these guys on the ice, with the exception of Stevens, Hall of Famer, you're afraid to take penalties. You can't be aggressive. No hooking, no clutching, no grabbing, no holding. Because anytime you do take a penalty, chances are you're going back to center.
We'll find out what they can do with a power play right now. Guard in the penalty box. And a 4-4 tie. We're winding down here in the second half. It's Legends game. Coffee. Pick the pace up a little bit. Down back the near side. Lemieux gets it to Larry Murphy. Shuffle a pass to Paul Coffey. Back to Big Murph. Back in front. Stevens turns and shoots it. That's going to be stopped. Picked up by Coffey. Again, the Penguins moving that puck around. That's exactly what we were talking about. Murphy in front of redirect by Francis is in the net. Ronnie Francis gets that stick on it. High five yourself.
Maybe. Boom goes the dynamite.
Yeah.
I have seen that before. Oh.
Yeah, I have to use a line. I've seen that fish before.
Yeah, well, you know what? It's got all the elements of what we had talked about initially. You know, the Larry Murphy has his head up at the point. You know, he knows that he's got Francis there. It's not a shot. It's not a pass. It's something in between. You can tip it. You can redirect it. You can stop it. You can do all the different things with it. But it's the 7 and 8 passes beforehand. Full control, full composure. And you know, this is just another chapter in what the Penguins have had for many years, and that's great players, great power play, great finishers.
So it's wrong. He's ridiculous at times. He is.
To see the game through Mario's eyes, just for a period, must be something special.
I'll tell you how I describe it. When you watch.
Come get it. Here, I got it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Keep away.
And there's a cross rink pass. Murphy's wide open. And a little collision at the net. Risling ran into the goaltender, but the whistle had sounded. No goal. No goal. He's really going to get caught for goalie interference here.
He knows he's busted, but he's getting away with one. And he just sneakily puts the puck through their legs, plays the game at his own pace, slows it down to the pace that he wants. I mean, just his ability to transpose the game at a different speed to his speed, just exceptional.
Evason, he charges ahead of the Penguins in, but they've been blessed. Now, the puck shot right in by Bondra, and he has tied the game. Peter Bondra from 25. And guess what? We're not done yet. What we talked about earlier, he'll one shot, that's all he needs sometimes.
All he needs,
you know?
Yep. There you got just a few seconds left to go in the game.
Here's Côté with a late opportunity, and that almost got through. Ron Francis pulls it out of danger for Pittsburgh. A couple of number 10s out here. Francis.
They're bringing back with them gold. As we say hello, Canada, James Duffy with you. Welcome to the gold medal game of the 2011 World Junior Hockey Championship. Team Canada came to Buffalo to avenge the loss last year to the Americans in Saskatoon in the gold medal game. They have done that. But ask every player on this team and they will tell you the same thing. That victory will mean nothing if they don't finish it off and win gold tonight against that other old arch rival. 10th straight gold medal game for Canada, 6th against the Russians. You'll see the teams taking to the ice and the bedlam that will surely follow right after this on TSN.
The 2011 IIHF World Junior Hockey Championship is brought to you by Imperial Oil, proud sponsor of Hockey Canada's World Juniors, by RBC Play Hockey, help hockey happen, by Nike, official training partner of Team Canada, and by TELUS, proud partner of Hockey Canada.
There are nearly 7 billion people on planet Earth, but among them walk a select few. They are the chosen ones, and they're answering the call. The 2011 NHL All-Star Weekend, only on Versus. And Stan Lee and the NHL present The Guardian Project, premiering in the NHL All-Star Game.
It's supposed to rain tomorrow. Probably can't paint the garage.
Really? Like I haven't seen that movie. I got this amazing meal of McDonald's Dollar Menu. The beefy McDouble, the crispy McChicken. Everything's so good and just a buck each. I'm smart enough to do all that, so my turn.
Can't paint, huh? Guess we'll just have to go look at window treatments.
Too easy. McDonald's Dollar Menu, the simple joy of being smart.
No one ever got better at hockey by bowling. More practice for you.
Show your commitment to the game with the U+ Crazy Light from CCM. Get your fit on.
Geico, saving people money on more than just car insurance.
The 2011 IIHF World Junior Hockey Championship is brought to you by the all-new Chevrolet Cruze. Don't just drive, cruise. And by Pepsi Max, zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste.
Scottie Bowman.